Pleasure now to actually introduce the executive this year. And I can tell you that they have been a hard-working executive as well as I have served a few years ago. Our rear commodore this year, and it, over the past couple of years, has been instrumental here in our node in getting us our new lease. And now we'll be charged on the which, if pandemic hadn't shown up, we'd be showing some results on that. We're very happy to have Bill back. The gentleman who keeps us organized when we have our meetings, make sure that all the log records are up to date. And of our problems. But, all that, Bill has kept us well on his great success. And hats off. We have some more to for those of you who spent a fair amount of time, you always see this gentleman working in the grounds. And in fact, right in the middle of that college school last week, he was working on the railing for Crow's Nest. I don't know where we'd be without Rolly. He dedicates himself to the club and is constantly improving things down here. And it's a blessing to have him as our property director. There we go, Rolly. Rolly, you got the applause. None of the other executives. Next up is, here in the middle of this challenge, one of the things that's most important in this club in terms of its future and our ability to attract new sailors is our sailors. Despite what's going on, Craig Thompson was able to come up with a program. And we are actually executing against it. We have families who are taking sailing lessons and it's sold out. And in August, we have a similar program running. So we've actually been able to execute against the sailing school, right? And Craig has done a great job getting to that stage. One of the best things about our program here at our club is our rural boat. And a testament to it is that the guy who came out of the program running, and his first boat was bigger than, half the boat at the club. He's done a wonderful job transitioning through just being a member and now being on the executive and contributes on a regular basis to all the things that we're doing, and was actually able to put together the Coral Boat Program and get the Coral Boat Program launched this year. Second last but not least is a guy who came up to socially forward guy. Maybe I should be the social director. So we'll be the social director. And he's done, even though we don't have much of a special, and he's the one that makes sure that all of you get your volunteer hours in. He's done a great job of getting people out to help us with this whole process. And the last individual is the one that talked about me earlier. I'd like to talk about Joel. Last year, another challenging year with my partner, and we had Joel transitioned from what was going on to club into this year, and we are blessed to have him. He's the only member of the executive who didn't have to face election this year. Past Governor, I'm looking forward to the next year. Past Governor just gets the point of stuff. Anyway, with that, please welcome your incoming. Next up is the new members.
Pierre.
So, I'd like you to walk here for another Pierre. Pierre, who's our membership director.
Here.
Why is he standing here?
Front and center. Right here. Cameron.
Good afternoon to you all at this 2020 staff house. First to be broadcasted live on channel 72. Of time, and to minimize my airtime, I will acknowledge and commit to the name of the members. The members will receive an OMI as per and you can probably display them Chris and Patricia Noriega, John Summers and Wendy Cooper, intermediate members, Angus McKenzie, Aaron Saunders, small craft members, Myra, Adam Clark, Lisa Linden, Dinah Gersh-Trask, Mike McCormick, Toro Ato, Jonathan,
Peter. Sailpast once he gave up the goal. We lost John almost 6 years ago, and I still think of him from time to time, and especially at this time of year. In his memory, I carry on this care they shelter me. Thou preparest a harbor before me in the homeland of eternity. Thou appointest the waves with oil. My ship plaineth calmly. Surely sunlight and starlight shall favor me in the voyages I shall take, and I shall rest in the port of my God forever. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, creator of all things and all people, bless we pray thee. Safe havens. We ask this in thy name. Amen. Please join me in our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. As it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. And we forgive them who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Not only for those who may have gone to the dark side of marine navigation, but also to neighboring clubs. Caps on.
Thank you, Peter, for the wonderful blessing. As we near the end of these formal ceremonies, I would like to invite our race director, Les Springer, to the podium to explain to the members what the Sailpast protocol and the dressing of the ships.
Welcome, buddy. I got the Indian. your headgear, dip your ensign. Everyone have fun and stay safe. Cheers, everybody.
Thank you, Wes. Finally, I would like to present a toast, or the toast that I want to be here, to Murray and Piper.
Thank you.